Hi guys, it's another Sunday afternoon in Rally Junkie's garage. You have seen in the last episode that we have made some preliminary sketches, and now we have gone further. Now we have almost final dimensions, and from that we have made some calculations for the suspension links and upright or knuckle weight calculations, so we can make some calculations for the new springs. The dampers will stay the same, only we have sent them to Protlon to make some adjustments. Last season was the first season for this car, complete season, and we gained some experience and we were changing our setup through the rallies, and now we have made some conclusions so we can change our setup, hopefully for the better. But we are no by any mean any automotive engineer or professional in this, so we are doing it for fun and to learn something. Before we continue, I will show you some good YouTube channels and webpage where you can learn more about suspension geometry parameters like roll center, roll steer, bump steer, and so on. People that talk on these channels are automotive engineers, and they can explain this better than me. And what I will focus on is rally suspension. Why? You will see on these channels and on the web, you cannot find a lot of data about rally suspension. All the people focuses on F1 cars and circuit racing cars, and that suspension cannot relate to a rally suspension. Why? If you have seen WRC events, you see that even on tarmac, no circuit car can compete with a rally car. Why? Because even on tarmac events, there is a lot of gravel and mud or dirt on a tarmac. In rally stages on tarmac, you have so big crests that the car often fly in the air for several meters. And you often have very bumpy sections where suspension have to do tremendous amount of work. So we can conclude that a rally car have to have suspension travel like a buggy. It has to be nimble like a go-kart, and on a high speed has to be stable as an F1 car. So you see that we will do many compromises to satisfy all that. Here I will show you a starting suspension parameters of our independent rear suspension. What you have to look is those two quadrants. You will see here an X dimension and there is a Y dimension. X dimension shows you of bump or drop, so if the damper extrudes or compresses. And what our main concern is roll center height and camber gain. You see that we have achieved of 135 millimeters. Roll center height, and this is way lower than we had on solid axle, so we have to use now sway bar. On solid axle we did not use sway bar because roll center was about 200 millimeters. For this roll center we have achieved a pretty good camber gain, and you see that in static position we used now only 0.5 degree of negative camber at the rear, and this can be easily changed, but this will be some starting position. You see that on a bump we gain some good negative camber, and on a drop or a extrusion of a damper we don't get any excessive positive camber gain. What is also an important parameter is bump steer.
So you see that we don't have almost any of the steer. 0.13 or 14 degrees for an 80 millimeter of travel is really not a concern. Also, you can see for a drop. What you see here is some anti-squat, and we have 46% of anti-squat. Will this be enough or not? We'll see that also on a track, and we can easily adjust that. In the next episode, we will show you stress testing of our independent rear suspension, and I will start a new series of videos about suspension geometry.